A memorial ceremony honoring a great sportsman and a patriotic American ushers in the ski jumping season at Bear Mountain Park, New York. The third annual Torger Tokle meet, commemorating the name of the former champion killed in action in Italy, gets away to a flying start before a huge throng of winter sports fanciers. A big field of 70 jumpers is dominated right from the start by the Norwegian entries. That's Odd Harsheim of Oslo, winner in the Class A contest, and second laurels to Art Tokle, Torger's brother. The inaugural meet of the season is not complete without the usual spills. Flying isn't the problem, it's the landing that hurts. Down you come, and fickle fate hangs in the balance. That's just it, a skier needs balance. And when you lose it, well, you run into all kinds of people. The 22nd Golden Gloves Championships get away to a rip-roaring start as Henry Mezatesta in the striped trunks mixes it with James Lilly in the 126-pound Sub-Novice class. Lilly goes into a huddle with himself, and Mezatesta gets in some solid socks all around before the air gets full of knuckles again. This time, the glove is on the other foot for a minute, but pretty soon, death and destruction catches up with Lilly, who goes into that self-clinch of his, with Mezatesta performing on the kettle drum. But the tune doesn't satisfy the maestro, and he takes a quarter rest. Once more, Lilly takes a repeat, and Mezatesta says anyone with half a head would stop this skull practice before he blows his top. The two scrappers trading blows at the Brooklyn Theater are fighting unattached. Come on, get together! And get together they do, with Lilly in there slugging and chasing Mezatesta to cover for a change. At this point, Lilly becomes bored with the leather pushing. Or does he? Or maybe again it is that he does. Now Mezatesta fixes Lily's train of cars with a few roundhouse wallops that stop him in his tracks. Mezatesta walks into a red light, and for a while the atmosphere is full of leather going in any direction. Mezatesta stops another, but time is running out for Lily, and the upshot of the whole slugfest is that Mezatesta cops the judge's nod. We'll be right back.